Morning everyone, how are you all? I hope you all will be fine and healthy. Okay, so today we are going to start a new chapter of sentences. Okay, so this class is basically for class 5. Okay, because in every class sentences have different forms. We learn sentences in different categories. Okay, so here we are going to learn sentences. Okay, as where the sentences have been started. So, what is sentence? Okay, so as you know, that sentence, a group of words which makes sense, that is sentence, okay, or is called sentence. So, in this book, the format of sentences are given, but that is different. So, we are going to read from your book, okay. So, there are two major parts of sentences, that is, first one is subject and second one is predicate. When we write a sentence, we always use subject, and for what we are talking, that is predicate. So mainly, what is subject? A sentence has two main parts, okay, subject and predicate. A subject is the part of sentence which shows about what or who we are talking about in a sentence. So if I am saying that Sia is writing, so we are talking about what? Sia. So Sia will be subject. And what she is doing, she is writing. So, is writing will be the predicate. So, without subject and predicate, we can't form a sentence. Okay? Now, in a sentence given in the beginning, children is the subject. A noun or a pronoun can be a subject. Okay? In a sentence, if it is raining. Okay? So, what is doing here? It is raining. So, it is a pronoun. So, it can be a subject. Understood? So it, in inverted comma, it can be a subject. Okay. So it doesn't matter, there has to be a name, doesn't matter. Noun or as well as pronoun, both can be a subject. Understood? Now, moving onwards, examples. Dolly is a young athlete. Okay. Now, Dolly is the name of a person, as you know. Dolly is a subject because we are talking about Dolly. Okay. And what she is athlete. Athlete means when anyone plays better, they go to this district level, state level, okay, they become athlete, okay, they experts, they are becoming experts of the, that playing background, so they are called athlete. And Dolly is a young athlete. Okay, so Dolly is mainly a name of a person, so it is a subject, and is a young athlete, it will be a predicate. Understood? Now, she became the winner. Now, she is, tell me student, she is a pronoun, isn't it? She is a pronoun. So, she will be a subject here, and is the winner will be a predicate. Okay? So, clear it. A subject can be even more than one word. Yes? It does not mean that only the first word, whatever it is given, it is only the subject. No, it can be more than one, two, three more words. Okay, and predicate can be some more words. The girl gifted ran very fast. The gifted girl ran very fast. Okay, so the gifted girl will be the subject, ran very fast will be the predicate. Only keep in your mind that subject means about what or who we are talking. Okay, until and unless the subject will not finish, we can't start our predicate. Understood? So recognizing subject is very easy, and recognizing predicate is also very easy. Okay, a predicate. Now, what is predicate? A predicate is the part, okay, that tells something about the subject. Dolly is dancing. So what Dolly is doing? She is dancing. So dancing is saying about Dolly. So that is a predicate. So Dolly will be the subject and is dancing will be the predicate. Understood? So I told you that recognizing predicate is more easier than subject. Understood? In a sentence given in the beginning of the chapter, are playing, will go, home after playing are predicates. Okay, when you read your book, when you do the exercises, let's learn. In that, you will get to know about all these factors. Okay, a simple predicate must have a verb. Okay, a simple predicate must have a verb. As I told you, it rains. Okay, it rains. Okay, so now rains is a verb here. Okay, and it is a pronoun. Understood? So it will be, we are marking it as a subject, and rains will be the pronoun. predicate. Okay, so a simple predicate contains verb. Okay, now see, Piyush sings, as I told you. So Piyush is the name of a person, so it will be subject, and sings, as he is doing some action, so it will be a verb and it will be a predicate. Okay, a predicate can contain more than one word. As I told you before, a predicate can also contain more than one word, like subject. Piyush sings melodious songs, so Piyush will be the subject, and sings melodious song will be a predicate. Okay, now moving on words. Apart from the subject, all words in a simple sentence are part of a predicate in which a verb is compulsory. Okay, now when we write a sentence, if there is not an action word, if there is not a verb, then what we will underline? Then if we will not add verb in a sentence, it means the whole sentence is the subject. Okay, there is nothing without verb. Okay, if I am saying, I am standing here and I am giving lecture, so what I am doing? What I am doing, my verb has been considered here. Okay, so leaving my name, rest sentence will be the predicate. Understood? So in a sentence, giving verb is important to make a complete sentence. Understood? In imperative sentences, the predicate is not mentioned. It is understood. Okay. As you know, what is imperative sentences? It is basically request, command. Okay, and when we give order. So these all are imperative sentences. Please switch on the light, come here, sit down, let's go. These all are sentences. It does not contain any subject. Understood? It is only understood by your own self. Okay, so understand that you are the subject, but it is not needed to be mentioned. Okay, if I am saying to you, please come here, so you will know that ma'am is calling me. So it has been understood, not mentioned. Okay, I don't have to mention what is subject here, because I am telling to you, you know. Okay, so this is the basic part of subject and predicate, and the two major name of sentences, or two major parts of sentences, is subject and predicate. Okay, so when we talk about the exercises, so what in your book, in page number 128, exercises is given here. Draw a slash to separate sentence subject for the predicate and underline the verb in each sentence. Class 5 plays during PE class. Okay, now class 5, for class 5 we are talking. Yes, for class 5 we are talking. So class 5 will be the subject, and rest all remaining words are the predicate. Okay, so after class 5, put a slash like that. Okay, and after remaining all the written words are subject. So in that you have to underline the verb also. Okay, so always understand that, always keep in your mind, after leaving the subject, the third or the fourth or any of the word which is written after separating the subject, it will also always be verb. Like class 5 plays during PE class. Okay, so if I am writing class 5 is subject, so what is the second sentence? Plays. So plays will be the verb here. So underline the plays. Come to the next sentence, so we will understand it. I like games. I will be the subject here. Now what the action word? Like. Underline the like, that will be your verb, and games, predicate. Understood? Third one. The trainers train the participants. The trainer trains the participants. The trainer, till trainer, it will be the subject. What he is doing? Trains. He is giving the training. So trains will be the verb, and rest all the predicate. Likewise, you have to do this exercise in your notebook and send it to me, and I will prepare some of the worksheet related to that, sentences, subject and predicate, and I'll send it to you. Thank you.